sure that I've got everything ready with me. I'm going to start with my pencil because we're going to do a sketch first. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to decide where I want him on my board. And I want him kind of closer to the ground here, even though we're not painting a ground, closer to the ground here than I do up here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with a little bit of like an egg shape. And I'm going to try that however far in I come on this side, I do the same thing on this side. And what's easier for me is to go ahead and turn my canvas, and I don't want to go all the way to the bottom, but I like to turn my canvas so that that just is easier. And I'm going to come right back up here. I'm going to round off this top. And then I'm just going to kind of look at that and decide if everything's pretty even. You guys don't need to draw as dark. I want to make sure that I am drawing dark enough for you guys to be able to see there. I'm just going to erase a little bit of these lines here so that I can see it better. So I've got my shape there. And then what I'm going to do, so once you've got this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give them two little ears. And it's not going to be just a triangle, but it's going to be similar too. So we're going to have that pointy edge here. I'm going to curve my line just a little bit right here. And then I'm going to come back down and have it meet back like that. And then again, whatever I do on this side, I'm going to try and do on this side. I've got a curved line, and then I'm going to look at this line. I'm going to pretend there's a line right here, and I'm going to make it even, I'm going to kind of give myself a guide as to where I need to come down to, and that's just going to help make them a little bit more even. And same with up here. We want to make sure that they're about the same height right there. And then what I'm going to do is where his wings are, or her wings, we're going to kind of bounce this out just a little bit. So it's just a little bit wider there, and then I'm going to do the same thing. So I'm going to figure out kind of where I started that. I'm going to have that imaginary line, and then I'm going to kind of bounce out, and I'm going to come, and I'm going to find where it stops here, make my little mark so that I know where to go to, kind of like that. All right. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to work on his eyes. And when we're working on an owl, we know that one of the biggest features on an owl is his eyes. So we want them to take up a fair amount of space. And so what's going to happen is if I were to find the halfway point on my owl, I would want to come up just a little bit more than that. And that's going to be the lower part of my eyes. And then I want it to fit. You know, I don't want to go outside of here. So I want it to fit. So I kind of want to use owl's forehead as my gauge here of how high to go. And again, whatever I do on one side, I want to try my best to keep consistent on the other. And if you need to spin it or turn it at any time, whatever makes it easier for you. And again, just go ahead and line up those points and see if you are the same height and the same width. See how over here I can tell I'm a little bit off over here. So I'm going to kind of consider what I want to do. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this eye over this way just a smidge. But I don't want to shrink it too much because we want that eye to be a good size. There we go. So I'm pretty content with that. So you kind of want to take a minute right now and you kind of want to look at those eyes because that is one of the biggest features. So take your time, kind of decide what you want to do there. Then what we're going to do is we're going to figure out his beak. And his beak is just going to be a simple diamond shape. I want it to go a little bit into where his eyes are, but I also want it to be down below here where it ends. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to figure out the top part of his beak first. And I don't want to go as wide as his eyes, but I want to go a fair amount. And I'm going to come down just a little bit lower than his eyes, like that. So there's part of my diamond. Then I'm going to go ahead, and with the diamond, I want to make sure that if I were to cut it in half, it's the same on both sides. So that's how I know where to end my diamond shape. And then the last thing that we're going to draw is we're going to draw where his wings go. So remember how we bumped out this little side over here? What I'm going to do is I'm going to give it a curve. And then that way we know where his wings are. Just like that. So now we've got everything sketched out. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to take a second, and you can see all of my pencil. And certain colors it won't do anything, and other colors it will. So what I want to do right now is I want to take the time and I want to erase the lines that I don't need. So I've got a good eraser here, and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to erase all those lines that I don't need, so that way I don't get confused once I actually go to do the painting. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to erase the line that's in the wing right now. So that one's gone. And then I'm going to erase the line in the other wing. And it's important that we do this so that way we don't get confused kind of as we're trying to paint. It's very simple to think, oh, wait a second, what did this line go to? And then right up here, I've got kind of some smudges, and I just want to get rid of those for my own reasons. They'll bother me. Okay. And you want to be careful that you're wiping your eraser onto the table and not into your paint. So everything else, right in the diamond, I drew that little line cutting it in half. Everything else, oh wait, we do want to make his ears go right into his body so he doesn't have any line in his ear there. So this is his actual line work that we want for when we go to start painting. And then one more thing that we do want to draw that I didn't think of was his eyes. So what we're going to do is we are going to cut the eyes in half here, and I'm going to make my first line right at the halfway point as straight as I possibly can on both eyes, and then I'm going to go just a little bit higher up, just a smidge, and I'm going to give them one more line, and so they should be pretty even. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to make an oval on the inside of his eye, and again I want to try and make them the same size. Like that. And then there's going to be one more oval that goes inside of there. So you've got that. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to get that paint ready. We want to make sure those eyes are as close to the same as we can. So go ahead and take the time and really play with those eyes to make sure. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and get that paint ready. The first thing that we're going to do, make sure all of your eraser is off and remember not to put it in the paint. Then I'm going to go ahead and give him kind of a pink background. So I'm going to use a little bit of red and a little bit of white. And how dark you make it is up to you. I'm going to mix some of it right on my plate. And then sometimes I'll just be adding some in directly onto my canvas. But for right now, I'm just going to get kind of a good starting point here of what I want. And we know that we're going to have to paint that whole background, so I want to mix a fair amount so that I don't have to try and match it up later. Okay, so now that I've got it mixed, and it doesn't have to be mixed perfectly, I don't mind a couple streaks here and there. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to start painting. Now for this one, what I like to do, because he's rounded, I'm going to kind of follow that same shape with my paintbrush, and it's just the way the brush strokes go. Now if we painted a solid color, you won't necessarily notice it as much, but if I go ahead and I go in, and like right now, if I were to add just a little bit of white, just to give it a little streak of white, if I go ahead and add it in like that, then you can kind of see that it's kind of rounded brush strokes. And that's just a fun thing to do. You don't have to do that. If I turn my brush sideways and press really lightly, even though I'm using my biggest brush, I can kind of go around the outside, and that way it's easier to come right up against him without painting inside of him. And then what I do is I just pull my brush out like this to fill in the rest of that space. But then, because I was doing those rounded brush strokes, I want to make sure while it's wet to go back over top of those parts so that you don't see any other odd brush stroke. So you got kind of that look going. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to finish painting this background. And again, you can go ahead and add streaks, then you can add red, you can add white, you can do kind of whatever you want here, but this is the main idea. I'm going to turn my brush again as I go around. And remember, we want to cover all of those white spots. So, whoops, got a little on him, that's okay. So notice, since I got a little on him, I just kind of wiped it away and I'll let that dry. And then we're doing just a darker version of this pink to paint him in. So that will cover nicely. But I got it on my thumb, so I'm gonna wipe my thumb off so that I don't do it again. And remember, if you wanna add those white streaks in or red streaks in, you wanna do it as it's wet. So like right here, I could go ahead and kinda add some white. I just put some white on my brush and it's just giving it a little bit of a lighter look. There we go. But I'm really focused on which way my brush is going so that it stays consistent. This is still wet up here, so I can add some more in. Now it gets harder as we go around to the other side, so you want to be careful. Notice I'm holding it where it's not wet. And I'm going to go ahead, do that outline again, and then pull that paint away. And then go back over top of it to blend that right in. There we go. Now again, keep in mind, as you're painting this background, that you don't want giant globs of paint. So if all of a sudden you've got something really thick like that, you want to make sure that you go through and you really spread that out. That's going to really help this dry. It's going to be easier as you go so that you can keep painting and you're not waiting on the dry time. So I've got that all filled in. So I'm going to go ahead and add a couple more streaks like this, and then I'm good to go. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put him down and I'm going to give him a couple minutes here to dry, just to make it a little bit easier. And I'm going to scrub out my brush, so I'm going to tap it on the bottom of my water cup. That's going to get the majority of my paint out. If I just swirl it around, it's going to get some of the paint out, but it won't get all of it out. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to wipe it on the side of my brush, or on the side of my cup, sorry. And that'll get that extra water out. And then you're going to take the paper towel and you're going to squeeze it dry. And then your brush will be ready to go for the next part. So for the next part, what we're going to start with, instead of starting with the body, I want this part to dry more before I start with the body. Oh, you know what? I see spots. I don't know if you can see these. Right here, there's little white spots. And so what I'm going to do is I want to make sure that I go back and I fill those in. Trying to fill it in later might be a little bit trickier, trying to match that color. So I want to make sure that I go through and I do that. I'm going to wash off that brush again. So while I'm waiting for that part to dry, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start working on his eyes. So what we're going to do is we're going to hold it however you're comfortable, but again, you don't want to be sticking your thumb in wet paint, so you want to be careful with that. And what I'm going to do first is I'm going to give him a blue eyelid up here. And I think, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to use, nope, you know what, I'm going to use my smallest brush and we'll give it an outline first just so that way you guys can get an idea. So I'm going to take a little bit of this blue paint and I'm going to make a nice light blue. We don't need a ton because we just need it for his eyelids, but you need enough for two eyelids. So you just want to think about that as you're going. So I'm just using the blue and a little bit of white here. And you can go as light or as dark as you want. I'm going to go a little bit lighter. And then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to fill in this spot. My hand was very shaky. So I'm going to go back over it. Fill in this spot. If you can't find a good way to steady your hand and you need your painting to dry, go ahead and take that break and let it dry. It won't take long and it'll make it easier for you. So if that's better for you, go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and do the other side here. Got some paint on my hands. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to outline in here. Fill this in. I'm just pulling the paint down. I'm not scrubbing it back and forth because I don't want to break my brush. Just kind of pulling that paint down. Now again, what tends to happen is when we're doing things like this, you might get some thicker lines of paint. So I want you to go back and if you even need to, you can wipe off your brush. If you've got too much paint on your brush, you can even wipe off your brush. And then come back and pull that extra paint up. And that helps spread that out so that you don't have a thick line of paint. And again, that's important because when we go to move on for the next steps, we really want that to be dry. Otherwise, it's going to smear it. And we want to avoid that if we can. We're not going to worry if it happens, but we want to avoid it. So I've got that done. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to rinse out that brush. And again, I'm going to kind of tap it on the bottom. With this one, since it's the smallest one, you want to be a little bit more careful with it. Wipe it on the side. Dry it off real good. Make sure, too, as you're drying off your brushes, that you're drying off, if it gets wet up here, that you're drying that off, too. What'll happen otherwise is the water will collect in here, and then as you go to paint, it'll drip down, and you'll think, well, I've dried this off, and then all of a sudden water might come down. So you do want to be careful about that. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to roll this brush into my white paint, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to fill in not the line, not this line right underneath, but the sides of his eye. And I know it's kind of hard to see because we're painting white on white here, but you want to think about where the white would be in an eye, and that's what we're filling in. I'm going to do it on both eyes. this. So I've got them both filled in. Go ahead and rinse out that brush. Again, make sure there's no thick lines. I don't think I saw any on mine, but make sure that there's no thick lines. Because if there are, that'll make it harder for later. The only thing that I do want to go over again, I do see this spot right here. I do want to go over that one more time because we want it nice and bright. Like that. So we can go ahead and rinse that brush off. And then what we're going to do is we are going to skip down now to the nose. Now, the yellow that we have is pretty bright, and I kind of want it to be a little bit softer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit of yellow and take a little bit of white and just soften that yellow, just so it's not as bright. I still want it to be a nice yellow, but I just like it a little lighter, and you don't have to. So I've got my brush, and I'm just kind of rolling it in here as it mixes together, and I'm just going to fill in this space. And again, I'm not going to scrub with the brush. I'm just pulling the paint down. I'm not super concerned of covering my pencil lines because at the end of this, we're going to end up giving them a little outline. And that's going to cover those pencil lines as well as we color in his main color. So I'm not super concerned about that. But I do want to make sure his shape is right. There we go. And then if you look, this line right here, we're going to fill this in yellow, but I really want to be sure that my blue is dry. And I can see some wet spots up here, but they're not wet right along this line. So I should be able to go in and I should be able to paint this line in. But if yours is wet, let it dry for a minute first and then go do it. You don't want it to smear. Patience is a huge part of painting things like this. It's better to be patient than to have to try and fix something. So I'm going to go to this side. I want this a little bit taller here. Like that. So I've got his eyes filled in there. And then what I'm going to do next is I'm going to roll this brush into my black. I'm going to do the inside of his eyes first because my white is still pretty wet and I want to give that a little bit more time to dry. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill in the inside oval with black. And notice how slowly I'm going and how carefully I'm going. You don't want to rush it too much because again, then you have to fix something if you slip or slide. And if you do need to fix something, you want to wipe it away very carefully and then you want to let it dry and then you'll paint over it. But you really want to avoid that when you can. But it's very important that if you do it, that you make sure that it's completely dry first. Otherwise, what's going to happen if this black were to scoot over here and then I didn't let it dry, or I wiped it away and I let it dry most of the way, but I didn't let it dry the whole way, then I'm going to go over it with another color and it's going to smear it because even just the smallest amount will make it smear. So I want to really try to avoid that. I'm going to go through to his next eye. Just like that. All right. So then we're gonna let those eyes dry before I do the brown part. Plus, I'm not ready for the brown anywhere else yet, so I don't wanna mix my brown until I'm ready to mix my brown. So I'm gonna leave that the rest of that eye for that. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go back to my biggest brush and I'm gonna fill in his whole body. And what I want is I want it to be the same tone here, but I want it to be a little bit darker than this one. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna add more red to what I already have mixed. Now the best way to know if it's dark enough or kind of what shade we're going up against is to have a little bit of the original color stay on your plate. So that way, you can kind of compare it and you're not trying to mix it on your canvas. So I added just a little bit of white in because I don't want it to be completely red. So I've got just a little bit of a darker color. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna come in and I'm just gonna start filling this in. Now again, as I come up to other spots, one, I wanna pay attention to whether or not those spots are dry, because again, if I get too close and then all of a sudden it smears. But two, I wanna remember that I wanna be real careful, turn that brush the right way and then pull that paint away, just like we were doing before. And again, turn that canvas whatever way is most comfortable to you. We're gonna pull it away. And then I'm gonna come around here. Fill this in. You want to get a nice smooth line. So to get a smooth line, you want to make sure you've got enough paint on your brush. You want to make sure you go nice and slow. Take your time so that you can see where you're going. Going in around the eyes is pretty tricky, so if you need to switch brushes at any time to a smaller brush, remember we're all, even though we're doing this together, we're all gonna end up kind of with a little bit different of a look, because it's not, everybody kind of draws differently, everybody has a different style. So your nose might, or your beak might be closer to the eyes and you might not be able to fit this big brush in there. Don't try and force it. That will give you a big old mess. So instead, take the time, switch out brushes. The big thing to remember is if you switch brushes and you switch into like the small brush right now, what you don't want to do is you don't want to go to these big areas and try and fill them all in with the small brush. So you go through. Well, I'll show you. So you go through and you get some of the color on your brush and you go and you press lightly and carefully and you get that outline. And what that's doing is it's giving you that little buffer so that you can go back in with your bigger brush. So now I can go back in with my bigger brush and go up to it without worrying as much and feeling like I'm gonna hit that eye. If you need to mix more paint, remember to leave a little bit of that original color so that you know what color you're trying to mix. It's easier to see if it matches on the plate than to try and fix it once it's on the canvas. And this is now dry, so I'm able to hang on to it a little bit easier. I'm going to mix just a little bit more paint here. I'm not going to go into those wings because those are going to be brown. So I'm just doing the body and up around his eyes and all that good stuff. I know it seems tedious going so slow, but the slower you go and the more time you take, you know you're trying your hardest. And when you try your hardest, no matter what happens, you're going to be proud of yourself because you know you tried your best. Okay, and the last spot that I'm going to fill in here is going to be his ear. Again, if you want to switch out what brush you're using, go ahead and do that. Don't feel like just because I'm using one, you need to use the same one. It's whatever you're comfortable with. That's what's going to be most important. So we've got him like that. I'm going to look through, see if there's anything else I need to touch up or go back into. And then if I feel like I'm good to go, I'm going to go ahead and rinse off my brush. So again, I'm going to tap that on the bottom of the cup, wipe it on the side, and then squeeze it dry. You don't want to pull when you squeeze it dry either. You just want to squeeze it dry. All right. Next thing we're going to do, we got to make brown. So in order to make brown, we need to think of our color wheel and we need to think of our opposite colors. So if I were to mix red and blue, I'm going to make purple. If I were to mix yellow and blue, I'm going to make green. And so what I want to do is if I'm thinking of the color wheel, the opposite of red is going to be green. And so if I mix those together, that's what's going to give me brown. So we want to get a little bit of green. So I'm going to mix some yellow and blue so that we get some green here. And then I'm going to take some red. So I mixed my yellow and blue and made some green, and then I threw some red in there. I feel like it's not the color that I want yet, so I'm going to just mix a little bit more yellow in here, a little more blue. And you guys can kind of just play around with it until you find the actual shade of brown that you want. That's getting closer to what I want. So again, everybody's tastes are a little bit different here. So I want you to find the color that you want, but those are the three colors that you need in order to make it. Then what I'm going to do is I do want to darken it just a little bit. So I'm going to take just the smallest amount, just a tiny amount of black here. I don't have a ton. And I'm going to mix that in and see how much just that small amount changes things. So I'm going to use that as my brown. And I'm going to just go ahead and I'm just going to start filling this in. So we're just going to continue filling it in, and again, as we get up against those edges, We're going to make sure we've got a nice smooth line. I'm going to dip in, go to the other side here. Fill this in. Just like that. And then I'm gonna give myself some long brush strokes here just so it's not as choppy. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna rinse out that brush. I'm gonna let those wings dry, but I'm still gonna be using that brown. So I'm going to turn this upside down. I'm going to go to my smallest brush again. I'm going to roll it in that paint. And then I'm going to go to that outside oval in his eye. Again, I'm going to go very carefully. I'm resting my hand on my owl. So you want to make sure if you do that, that your paint is nice and dry. Otherwise, you're going to get a nice big handprint on there. But it does help steady your hand. Again, one of the biggest parts at this point is to have lots of good patience. And if you feel like your patience is not that good right now because you're frustrated or your hand feels shaky or your arm is tired or something like that, I want you to take a break. Because what we're going to end up doing is we're going to end up outlining. When we outline, we need this good patience. We need to take that time. So I'm going to go ahead here, rinse off that brush. All right, so I just noticed I somehow managed to get some paint up there. So I'm going to make sure it looks like it's dry. Yep, it's dry. So I'm going to go back with that blue, and I'm just going to hide that. And that happens. I'm going to rinse off that brush. So now what's going to happen is we're going to go ahead and we're going to start working on that outline. That outline is we're going to want to take our time. It's going to be really important that you have enough paint. So I feel like I'm running a little bit low. So I'm going to get my brush out again and I'm going to do that mix again. So I'm going to mix a little bit of green with my blue and my yellow, and then take a little bit of red and add that in there. I'm keeping some of my original color so I can see the exact color that I'm trying to make. Oops, I don't want to take too much red. It's always easier to keep adding colors than to try and take a color out. So you want to start with small amounts first. And then don't forget we added that little bit of black. So I'm going to add that little bit of black. And that should be pretty good. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get my brush nice and loaded up with paint here. I'm going to think of all the spots that could be wet before I steady my hand, but I really want to steady my hand. So if you're painting around this area is not dry yet, you want to put it down, let it dry for a few minutes, and come back. So what I'm going to do is I've got that brush loaded. I'm holding it like a pencil. I'm steadying my hand on my canvas, and then I'm pressing lightly. Remember, the harder you press with this brush, the wider your line's going to be. So if you want a wider line, go ahead and press harder. And if you want a thinner line, you want to barely press down. And then as you can see, I'm not picking up my brush until I either need to reload the paint or I find a nice stopping point. So here's my starting point. I'm going to drag that brush down. And then when I get to my stopping point, I simply lift up. And we're going to go around and again, make sure, like, this part's wet right here, so I want to make sure that I'm real cautious with where I put my hand to steady myself. I found my starting point. I'm dragging down. I can tell that I need to lift my brush up, so I'm just going to casually lift it up. I'm going to turn my canvas a little bit more. I'm going to figure out what's dry, where I can put my hand. I'm going to start back and kind of overlap with what I already had just to give myself a good starting point. And then I'm going to come back down. Same thing, I'm going to overlap just a little bit. And I'm going to come back down here. Come back up. Lift up. Now I do see that I have a little bit of a drag mark, so I'm going to go back over that spot just a little bit more. I'm going to find my starting point. Come down. Lift up. Come down and lift up. Now for this part, we want to go ahead and we want to actually leave a little bit of a gap. Just like that. So there's a little bit of a space there because we're going to fill that in with that pink color of his body. You don't have to do that, but it's just what I'm going to do here. I'm going to keep going. I'm going to follow that curve. I'm going to come right down. Now this outline, we should be spreading that paint really thin. So as I'm doing the bottom, the top is drying, which is good. Because we're going to need that top to be dry so that we can do around his eyes. But not least, I'm going to do that little gap on this side. I got lots of skips in there, so I'm going to go back in and carefully fill that in. Then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put this down. I want that top to be nice and dry before I work on the next part. So what I'm going to do while I'm waiting is I'm going to go back into those gaps with that tiny brush, and I'm going to fill in with that original body color here. You want to go real careful. Filling in all those white spots. Just like that. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Now again, that paint might be a little bit wet, so we're just going to be super careful. Just like that. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get more paint on my brush here. I'm using my smallest brush, and I'm going to start doing the outline around his eyes and his beak. And so what I'm going to do, I'm going to start with his beak. And again, the harder that we press, the wider the line. So you want to think about that and turn it however you need. Just remember to be aware of what's wet and what's not. Take your time, go slow. All right. Then what we're going to do is we're going to do the eyes. And we're just going to do the best that we can. Try and keep the same amount of pressure as you go. So that means try and keep the same amount as hard as you're pressing down. So whether you're pressing softly or lightly, try and keep the same amount as you're doing this outline. I'm going to stop here and I'm going to go across right at the yellow line. And then I'm going to go ahead and go up the top of the yellow line. You really want to make sure that you have enough paint on your brush. And as I study my hand, I'm thinking about what's wet and what's not. And then my brush is getting a little clumpy here, so I want to go ahead and I want to completely rinse that off. It's going to make my outline go a lot smoother. I'm going to mix some more paint. Okay, so I've got a good amount mixed here. I'm going to go back in with my smallest brush. Now that it's nice and cleaned off, I'm going to roll it again in here. And again, I want to try and stay consistent now with the other eye. So I don't want to do like a really thin line on one eye and a really thick line on the other eye. And though it's not going to be perfect, because you can't really measure that when you're painting, you want to just go ahead and make it as close as you can. And then going across this yellow. Now I want to go through and I want to look at anything else that I want to touch up. So you can kind of just glance, see if you've missed anything, see if anything stands out. And this is the time, go ahead, pause it, take a look at it, really make sure you're happy with how it's coming out. And then rinse out this brush. And the next thing we're going to do is his little feathers on his chest here. And what I need then is I need to have a turquoise, that light blue, and that light yellow. So to get that turquoise, I'm going to mix my blue and my yellow. And I only need a little bit. And I've got kind of like a green here. And I want it to be a little bit more blue than I do green. And then I'm going to lighten it up by using some white. And again, you're going to find the color that you like the best, but this is kind of what I'm going with here. Okay, so now I've got some paint on my brush here. All I'm going to do is I'm going to make a couple little feathers. I'm not making a lot because that's at the top, and I'm going to make the top row the smallest amount. But I am going to go in and I'm going to fix those lines to make sure they're nice and smooth. Fill in all those gaps. So that's the first row. Then I'm going to go down and I'm going to do a light blue like I did his eyes. And what I'm going to do now is I put that in the center and I'm going to go a little bit wider on each side for this one. And then I'm going to get a little bit of that yellow that we used on his eyes and on his beak. So it's a little bit softer. And I'm going to go just a little bit more as I come down. And I'm just kind of spacing them out the way that I want. Whoops, that one had a little bit of water on there. So what I'm going to do, see how that water got there? Just going to dab it. I'm not rubbing it. I'm just going to dab it just like that. Then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to squeeze my brush dry to make sure that wherever that water came from, we get it nice and dry. Dip right back into my yellow since it's the same color. And I'm going to go right back over that spot. Just like that. And then if I want to, I can go through and I can fill that pink back in if it was too bad. But again, when you fill that pink in, you're going to wait for it to be nice and dry. So then last but not least, we want to give them just a couple little highlighted spots here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to roll my smallest brush after I clean it off. You know what, I should make sure it's nice and dry again so I don't have another mishap. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to roll it into that white. And then I'm going to give him a little highlight right on top of his eyelid, a little rainbow shape. I'm going to do the same thing to the other side, just like that. And then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do a little highlight right on the black part of the eye. And notice how I'm curving it. I'm not doing a straight line. I'm curving it down. Just like that. And then I'm going to do one more highlight. It's going to be right on the left of his beak. Just like that. So now again, here's where we're at the point where we want to kind of look at him and we want to see if there's any spaces we should fill in, if there's anything we want to change, if there's anything that we want to do differently. So now's a good time to kind of pause it and check and look and fill in anything that you want to do.